I'm going to describe how we read a compressibility factor chart. And so what we're plotting is the compressibility factor. So Z is pressure times specific volume, volume per mole over gas constant, absolute temperature. We're plotting it versus reduced pressure, which means pressure over the critical pressure. And we have a series of curves as a function of reduced temperature, which is the temperature over the critical temperature. And so the idea is the theory of corresponding states says that properties, deviations from ideal gas are going to depend on where we are on the pressure temperature diagram relative to the critical pressure and temperature. And so if we have an ideal gas, that corresponds to Z equals 1. And then for various reduced temperatures, so for example, if reduced temperature is 1.14 and reduced pressure 1.63, we can read off this chart that the compressibility factor is 0.58. And so that would say the volume is going to be significantly less than what we calculate from the ideal gas law. Because I'm only using two parameters here, the critical pressure and the critical temperature for the plot, this means if I look at a different gas, the plot's going to look differently. And so what I want to do is now let's look at the interactive simulation that demonstrates this behavior. So here's the interactive simulation. It allows us to move the pointer around with a mouse, and notice that we're moving the blue line, and we can select a reduced pressure and a reduced temperature, and then read off the value for Z. If I switch to hydrogen, then for same conditions, of course, we're expecting different behavior. If I notice now switched in hexane, the compressibility factor at some conditions can be greater than 1. The simulation is limited to only allow us to go, just because the ease of programming only allow us to go to a compressibility factor of 1. And carbon dioxide, likewise, at high pressures and high temperatures can have compressibility factor greater than 1. And so this allows us, just using critical pressure and temperature, to get information about the 9 ideal properties and look at the behavior. And notice the shapes of the curves are similar for all of the gases. We could do additional correlations, create a couple sets of curves if we use in addition to critical pressure and temperature as eccentric factor.